is divided. But beyond time, everything is a part of God. Not of God divided, but of God united, resolved, and brought together into one. Within time, there is an eternity of agony for all beings not of God. But when time is no more, eternity is no more, the separation is no more. There is no condemnation, because there is no division. There is no damnation, because there is no separation. But until time is resolved, and all is brought together, we must bear its burden to the ultimate. We must span the scale from the highest to the lowest. We must feel the greatest joy and the greatest agony. We must embrace the ultimate salvation and the ultimate damnation. We must be the very best and the very worst. We must hate and we must love. We must learn perfection and adaptation. And we must know the separation in all its stark and unequivocal intensity. Before it can be transcended, it must be known and felt and experienced to the ultimate. Black must be the ultimate black, and white the ultimate white, and we must feel and know them both. For again, there must be separation, before there can be no separation. There must be the ultimate intensity of conflict, before there can be no conflict. The two ends of the universe must be disentangled, before they can be reunited, if we are hanging death, we are hanging death, we are disappearing, testifying, being told from our past, there are not be truly united things, until we have first been separated from it, or more accurately, until we have seen it in reality, when we are separated from it, by the barriers of our impulsive attachment to it, and until we have seen the true extent of our separation, because knowledge and awareness are always the only essentials when it comes to action. To see and to believe are all we are required to do of our own volition. From here we are free to follow, as far as we can, our instincts and our inclinations, to exercise our illusion of choice. Even to our own judgment and the signs that are to guide us. However choiceless we may consciously know ourselves to be, until that knowledge has become a truth to deep and profound awareness, both conscious and unconscious, there is still the illusion of choice, a basic sense of personal control of our destiny, a sense of individual responsibility. And as long as it is there, we must enact it ourselves. Is a part of our choicelessness, as is the fact that we shall inevitably fail. If we deny something about something ourselves, we fail to achieve this. It is basically a fact of choicelessness. cannot be read as quality, but the sounds are there. I was very evident to send you this. Master Sound, Father's needless to do, I suggest that it should be played on the program. Warn listeners in advance so they may have the option. Turn the radio off for 30 seconds while it plays. It has always haunted me. For those who discounted the Siberian sounds from Hell's Story, it is true, and I for one wish it wasn't. Rick, listening from Chicago. And so I submit that I bequeathed a better copy to you, and I warn you, what you are about to hear is very disturbing indeed.
Thank you. This is a good time to do the control EEG so we go next door. In less than 2 hours, as the illumination happens, in most subjects, we have faint that starts, and the frequency analyzer will show the battery emergence as frequency bands. Single light flash will block out the waste where this fast zone here does now. It will modify each time the visual field is expected to see, as it lies in the dark game of this last moment.
Thank you. shortwave antenna. Move more safely. Think it's your lessons. That was your mercy, going thing. Kelly, what a noble.
Thank you. Alpha 60.